Jeff! Yeah, you remember that happy-go-lucky guy? The one you told about his two-faced cheating slut of a wife?
I just took some photos. But yeah, how you doing now anyway? You leave that bitch?
You could say I cut some ties. Meet me at the garage off Silicon Street at the northeast corner of Middle Park. I need your help.
Process ensure that in 1,000 years you'll still look great.
What's going on?
Yeah. I got a bit of a problem. A bit of a big fucking problem.
What's going on?
Yeah. Jeff really did it this time. Jeff went too far. Jeff's been a bad boy. A really bad boy.
What are you saying, lunatic?
Remember my wife, Shirley? She had an accident in the kitchen.
What kind of an accident?
Oh, the kind of accident where you stab yourself 50 fucking times with a kitchen knife. You fucking whore. Fuck my friend, will you? Well, who's laughing now, bitch? Huh? Not you, you fucking dead whore.
Hey, buddy. Whoa, calm down.
Hey, fuck you.
Don't be an idiot. What do you want me to do?
Get rid of her and get rid of the car, hey?
Okay, but it's going to cost you. $5,000.
Sure, whatever.
Give me the keys. Put the gun away.
Yeah, okay, thanks. Oh, Jeff really messed up this time, didn't he? Oh.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cause we're getting paper. Hey, tell me again, where's it? I'm in the hood, top down. Put my cherry on. Cherry on. Cherry on. I got my goons on. Me. Niggas, is you with me? My bitches, is you with me? If you got a problem, I'm sucking you to get there. Y'all know my name. You seen the kid.
I got rid of that body for you. You should be clean. Now all you need to worry about is your conscience.
The whore! She brought this on herself. Practically stabbed herself by letting him give it to her. Thanks.
Don't make me fuck you up!
I want to go to Joliet.
One way to go.
Thank you very much. Roman, what's up? You want to join me at the show?
Sorry, cousin. I just see show with you. I can no go again.
We can make arrangement for another time.
This is Dwayne.
Nice to see you. A lot of action, a lot of
Yo, man, we've been friends for a while now. You wanna grab a bite or something?
Yes, I'm pretty hungry. I'll be over to you within an hour.
Cool. We'll see you soon.
Please make a U-turn. We're safe. Please proceed to highlighted route. Calculating route. Please make a U-turn. We're safe.
You ever spend time inside?
Prison? Sure, but I never did the long stretch.
It's strange, man. You start off worrying about all the usual shit. About some maniac trying to fuck you up the ass. About some other maniac who wants to slash your throat. About to offer food. Then that shit ceases to matter.
Yeah?
Yeah. You learn to cope with the environment. Make the best of it. Learn to scare people away from you. Get food smuggled in, you know.
Sure.
And after a while, you stop hurting. And that ain't the problem at all.
No?
Nah. Problem is, you realize it's all the same shit. In prison, outside, with the woman, on your own, with money, broke, happy, unhappy. Don't mean shit. Realize life don't mean shit, man. Teach yourself to stop caring.
I know about that.
But it's hard, man. I don't know how to fix that shit. I don't know how to care no more. Damn, listen to me. I'm pathetic. This kind of a fancy place. Think I'm gonna like this. That's some great food, man. Yo, can you take me back to Northwood? Control this shit!
One of 20th century's greatest geniuses.
200 yards. Turn left.
See you soon, man. That was a lot of fun. You a good guy, Nico.
Thank you. Welcome back to the Venturis Poker Challenge. While you were away, you missed something ridiculous.
The poker gods were smiling on dangerous Derek Thornton just now. He took the sport in a whole new...
Stuff Pollo Toto Frito, now at Cluck and Bell. Wow. The meal in one just got massive. Cluck and Bell.
Purely for research, of course, was that in the comatoriums, they used pig fat as lubrication, which in many ways is far superior.
Sexual news, the news Liberty City Trust.
Are you a sex offender? Find out tonight.
Ethnics are at it again. Weasel News is on the...
Americans felt, and rightly so, that they shouldn't have to pay any tax.
Crazy city. I'm enjoying it, though. It's very exciting. A lot of options here. You need want to leave, you gotta leave. Hot on you. You're gonna look smoking tonight. That's it, baby, just how I like it. Wow, I love that look, honey. Hope to see you very soon.
Thank you.
it's Nico Bellic. I'm here for an interview.
Come in, I'll buzz you through.
Welcome to Goldberg, Ligner, and Shyster, sir.
Mr. Bellic, welcome. I'll just see if Mr. Goldberg is available. Mr. Goldberg, Mr. Bellic has arrived for his interview.
Okay, great. Tell him to come through to my office.
Would you please follow me, Mr. Bellic?
Sure.
Excuse me, please. Hello?
Mr. Goldberg is such a saint. He teaches kids to swim, you know. He's just so warm and giving. All he cares about is making the world a better place. And boy, are you in trouble if you get in his way.
I always get nervous before interviews.
He's just in here. Don't be nervous. He doesn't bite.
Hello, Nico. What's that short for, Nikolai? I'm looking for a man who can get jobs done right. Nikolai, I like your resume. You seem to be the sort of man who would go the extra distance. I just need to take another look. Get myself reacquainted with your experience. So, you're the sort of man who doesn't wait to get told what to do. A guy who looks at the world, sees problems, and tries to fix them?
Sure.
My problem is that people don't notice the decay in society. They leave the decay alone, and soon it's too late, so you have to pull the whole tooth.
Yeah?
I am the guy who goes around shaking people. For people, read society, read City Hall. I shake them, and I say floss. Get rid of the rotting flesh stuck in your teeth. Prevent decay. Mouthwash, you hear me? There's this cop. Good cop, but he thinks he's above the law. He's not. You wanna know why? Because the law is clear. I'm gonna crush him into dust. No one is above my judgment. You understand me?
Okay.
Here at GLNS, we're pushing things to the limit. We're on the front line, young man. A man I was recently with in this office, in this very room, was murdered. You gotta fight for what is just in this world.
You do.
Anyway, give me an example of some time where you've worked as part of a team.
I work alone.
So, are you going to expand on that, or are you just going to hang around like a chump? Damn these quotas. You end up with every dumb immigrant in the city coming in for interviews. Security, get in here, we've got a problem. Standing up. Assertive move, right. I like a man who takes control. Modupe, get in here. Would you remove this gentleman from the building? He's wasting my time. And while you're at it, take a look in the can, will you? I think I blocked it up pretty good.
What is this shit? Messing with the wrong guy. Don't make me kill you.
This grudge is not over!
Help
is
you me! Crazy?
You can't just be hit, folks!
The violence behind the Columbia!
Shots have been fired at the offices of Goldberg, Ligner, and Shyster. Employ extreme discretion before using your weapons. We don't need any more lawsuits.
Hi, you punk! Go on back!
dispatch. I'm continuing on foot.
You're getting robbed. Stay calm.
May Poseidon swallow you whole.
I gotcha. All right. Listen, give me the microphone back. Listen, I agree with you. I mean, the fashion's in big trouble in this city. Women, sometimes, like you say, are so attractive you can't help but bite them.
Yeah.
And then there's other women that are wearing like those lime green and orange rubber clog sandals. Ugh. I mean, women are wearing tent curtains now that make them look pregnant. I mean, men wearing women's jeans. I mean, you get in trouble for hanging outside a women's clinic down a cruise on chicks.
You get in trouble for that? Okay.
What happened to freedom in this city, I mean, the mayor's shutting down the porn stores, banning smoking and trying to outlaw fun.
But there's more places you can go, man. You can find some more places to find out.
Like schools. Could you really not rub your junk? Why not talk about
it? Why not? Let me just do it for a little while.
Dude, listen.
Schools.
Stop. Listen, dude. Just finish it. I don't want to be.
There we go.
I just don't want to.
There we go.
I just don't want to be.
That's it. That's all I wanted to do. And there it is.
Okay.
I want
to give you blue balls on my radio show.
What a day.
I mean, I'm talking about the glory days in love. I mean, if you think back to when 16-year-olds could drink and listen to metal music, when you could smoke in bars, you get into high-speed accidents, you go, dude, I lost my right arm. And your friends would say, dude, who cares? You can drum.
Totally.
I mean, it's like.
You could do it with your sister.
Dude, shut up.
Here are the files.
Great! Peace at last! I feel cleansed. You silenced Goldberg too, right? I don't need to worry about him?
He's done.
Whoa, music to my ears! A weight has been lifted. Here's your payment.
Line all day for this ride called life. You sweat, you hate yourself, and then it's over in 45 seconds, and she looks at you, she says, I have to go, and she sort of leaves the room awkwardly, and you just wish that once you could share a bed with someone. I get creeped out by the pictures of my ex-wife on the nightstand. I gotta take a break.
The Bittersweet Personal Email Device, always on.
I love it. It goes off like every minute. No matter where I am or who I'm with, it vibrates the second I get an email, so I can stop what I'm doing and read an unimportant email from HR or one of the 80 spam messages I get each day. It really helps me stay focused.
Childhood watching BTV and guzzling pipe fructose corn syrup didn't give you enough attention deficit disorder, all isn't lost. Never had a spare moment with a Bittersweet Personal Email Device. Finally, be really productive. Get drunk and send suggestive emails to a coworker. Motivate colleagues by sending cryptic, furious email rants in the middle of the night. Be everywhere and nowhere with instant email. The Bittersweet. Available soon at Badger Wireless locations.
He's getting older, but not wiser. It's Laszlo.
Oh my God!
Hey, have you many dogs?
It makes for a strong society.
Ain't that the truth?
Give me the car, friend.
Oi! Fuck me!
Live radio show, meeting the real citizens of the city. Getting urban, like a music video, and I'm in slow mo. There's just girls dancing around me. Excuse me, young man. Do you want to be on the radio?
Young man, you trapped in the 70s. Nobody says young man. What else are you gonna say? Fresh?
Look.
What do you think you're doing?
I spent the last few years of my life in a gin martini getting shafted by the cruel fates of slow career suicide. The city makes you angry. It makes you want to rip a fool's head off. You know, bite people on their cheek for talking on a fucking mobile phone on the train. You know, bite people walking too slow up the stairs of the subway. You know, bite people that are more successful than me. It's like I'm radioactive.
Come in, Nico.
Hi.
So, you fought in the war?
You know a lot.
Yes, you're looking for some people.
We're all looking for that special someone.
But most of us don't want to kill them when we find them.
Most murders are committed by people you know. Most wives are killed by their husbands.
Yes, and my wife had better stop sleeping with that tennis coach or... I'm joking.
I'm sure your wife doesn't need to sleep around. Well, I'm joking. I'm sure she does.
Funny. I'm divorced. My wife can sleep with whoever she wants.
Interesting.
I'm not divorced. I was never married. No details. I need you to go find someone for me. I'll be getting a picture through shortly. This is important.
So why use me?
We always use people like you. Karen, Michelle, she was the same. Someone with something to lose, but not much to live for.
What's in it for me?
Two things. One, you don't get 100 murders pinned on you. Two, maybe I will help you. Maybe I won't. Now get access to a police computer and wait for my message. Go.
Hello, you're through to the Liberty City Emergency.
Hello, the LCPD. Where would you like us to send an officer?
The Triangle.
An LCPD peacekeeper will be there as soon as possible, sir.
So friendly.
Who's people? What
you
do
people.
You
people. Where are you from?
I'm from Central America. Hello.
I'm sorry. I'm stupefied. I can't really understand what you're saying. Can you?
You're stupid?
No. You got to work on the English a little.
You're stupid. Hey, you know what, man? You have to work on the
English. Let's go. Come on.
Here.
I found this place. There are a bunch of guys hanging around.
Well, he must be in there, Nico. Dispose of them all. We're doing a favor for our comrades in the East.
You better start doing me some favors soon.
Of your purpose?
Yes.
Then you are that much closer to finding the man you are after. That strange feeling deep inside? That's the feeling of satisfaction after you did something good. Congratulations. Goodbye.
Roman is your cousin. Any chance of getting a cab?
You need walk no longer. There's a cab coming to you.
Good, but he still get me to pick up his piss-faced cousin for free. Aren't I lucky, boy? This is a waste of my life. I hope you enjoy the trouble you are going to be getting into here.
So the plan was they were gonna hide the diamonds in the queen's ass.
Oh, hey, Nico.
Hey, Kate.
Get your fucking hands off my fucking sister, boy.
We're talking, not having casual sex, Patrick. I pray after the amount of practice you've had, you'd know the difference.
Sure, I know the difference. One leaves you feeling sad and empty and alone, and the other's casual sex.
And I'm quite sure you and Mr. Nico here will have fun on your play date.
Hey!
Coming, Ma! You boys play nice now.
For sure!
Hey.
Okay.
Oh, we're gonna play real nice. They're clean as a fucking whistle. One previous owner.
Yeah.
Safely driven, ready for action. We got an opportunity, my boy.
Yep. Fortune favors the brave.
Gotta make hay while the sun shines.
So is you down, boy? Or is you out?
Down for what?
Down for robbing a thief.
Robin Hood.
Exactly. Robin fucking Hood.
Who are you going to rob?
The fucking mafia, boy.
Is the money good? What's the risk?
Well, the risk is we all die a very slow and painful death. And the money is good, very good indeed.
So you in, big guy? Or we're gonna have to kill you.
Well, since you put it that way, I mean.
Right.
Good.
All right.
Let's go. Let's do this.
Can you get us a car, man? I'm afraid these two idiots can't drive for shit.
Fuck you, Packy.
Yeah, fuck you.
Calculating route. You have arrived.
Take us out to the waste management plant under the Algonquin Bridge on Colony Island.
Calculating route. Please make a U-turn where safe.
A mafia-controlled waste management plant?
You fucking guessed it. It's an Ancelotti operation. Ray tipped us off about a big payoff they just got. A fat cash payoff.
Ancelotti's, huh? I can't tell none of those block families apart. Ancelotti's, Gambino's, Pecorino's.
It's the fucking Pecorino's, man. We're working for them. Pecorino's a type of cheese. Pecorino's is a bunch of Guido gangsters out of Alden.
They're all mafia, though?
Of course they are. Cosa Nostra and all that shit. Our family used to be bigger than all them mafia families put together. Back in the day, that is.
Not this shit again. I heard this speech a million times. The McCrary's ran the city. People were scared to say their name, let alone come near their place in purgatory. Life was great. We were in charge.
It's fucking true. I'd like to hear you tell Gerald that it's a boring story. My brother wouldn't take too kindly to that now, would he? You know the purgatory is called what it is because people were so scared of the McCrary's? Did you know that, Nico?
It's called that because people found the McCrary story so fucking boring. Listening to them was like being in purgatory.
Fuck you, Gordon. I'll fucking come back there and kick your fucking ass in a minute.
I hear that Francis McCrary is your brother.
Fucking Frankie, my brother. He may have a badge, but I tell you for a fact, he's as crooked as the rest of us McCrearys. More so. At least we ain't fucking hypocrites. Kate's the only decent one.
I can believe that.
You know Frankie, do you? I got a story for you if you do.
Another fucking story.
Shut up, Gordon. So, Nico, when Francis and Gerald was growing up, Frankie becomes an altar boy. He swears to this day that he wanted to serve the Lord. Jerry knows the truth, though. He only put on that cassock so he could pocket the change in the collection plate. Fact. That's Francis, down to a fucking T. I don't even know if he realizes what a crook he is.
That sounds like the Francis McCrary I met.
I bet. Model community leader, my ass.
You're just worried he'll start clamping down on you. Ain't you, Packy?
I'd like to see him try it. Not gonna happen with the things Jerry knows. Here we are, boys. Moment of fucking truth. All right, boys. If Ray is correct, then the money's going to be kept in the office in the main building. And there should be a boat docked out back for the getaway. All right, it's up and over the fence. Nico, stick fucking close to me.
Just see you! My knee!
a look around, buddy. We got you.
Okay, kids, I got the cash! Shit! Looks like we're not the only ones after it!
Make a swim for it with the money.
See you back at the house, Packy.
Try to keep the money dry, won't ya? I don't know how my bookie's gonna be about wet notes.
Swimming for it, eh?
Sure, my boy. There's the boat just out there. I'll race you.
That don't mean I can drive one. Fuck it, though. I'll give it a try.
Remember this?
Now, for a moment you've all been waiting for, America's next top hooker is Crystal!
Oh my god, I'm so happy! I won and I'm being valued as a woman! Fuck you, bitches!
It's back this season on CMT. 20 girls from across America compete for the title everyone wants, America's Next.
That was fucking beautiful. We did ourselves proud. My brother Jerry's gonna be fucking ecstatic.
Providing the Angelotis don't figure out it was us and ripped them off.
I don't fucking worry about it. So this figure was another one of the five families. Us McCreary's are under the fucking radar nowadays. It ain't a problem.
I hope you're right. For my sake,
just shut up and think about the money. If that don't work, think about my sister. I tell you though, you're only getting your hands on one of those things, you maniac. And it ain't gonna be my Katie.
I'll think about the money then.
What a trooper. We did it. Top of the fucking world. Here's your share. Don't go spending it in any Italian restaurants.
I'll see you soon, Becky. Roman, what's up? Want to go to a show?
Nico, I just see show with you. Mallory will start to get jealous.
Sure, Roman. We do this some other time.
Hey, babe.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's phone. Unfortunately, I can't get to the phone.
That's a fuck. Yeah, I'm too fast for you.
Asshole!
Nico, man, look, I ain't a pimp or nothing.
What are you talking about, man?
I'm saying, you take my sister, Katie, out for a drink or something. She don't get out much, and she sure as hell not going to take you. We're starting to worry. She likes you, just as friends. I'm gonna send you another.
I'll give her a call, man, but, I don't think she'll want to see me.
Trust me, she will. Call her, man.
With our sponsor Zit. Radio, you hear a song, call Zit 948-555-0100. That's right, I'm walking the streets doing a show. This is live, people. This is radio.
Can you keep your voice down? You're talking too loud.
Hey, easy, honey. I'm on the radio.
Who cares what this is? Shut up.
Yeah. Can you wear a bag over your head? You're ugly. Go play some Sudoku and die peeing on yourself. You don't talk to the media like that. This is radio, in association with my mega-awesome sponsor, Zit. This is about people taking the city back from the media barons. I'm literally walking the streets of Liberty City, interviewing people, getting questions answered, you know? Discovering why people want to live in a crime-infested, overpriced dump without trees. Excuse me, sir. Can I speak to you for a minute? What do you want? I want you.
Hey, I'm not like that. I'm not a knob goblin.
Hey, listen. Chicks or MILFs with stretch marks. Besides, listen, dude, I'm famous. Do you want to be famous?
No way. I don't want the paparazzi taking pictures of me naked doing coke.
Sorry, bro, you're a little too late. You just made radio history. You're the very first guest on Integrity.
Nicky, this is Ray Pacino, the man keeping your Irish friends in liquor.
I thought I was doing that.
I hear you need work. I want to throw you a bone, Nicky. Come over to Drusilla's in Little Italy. We'll have a little sit-down.
You know, how come nobody on TV goes to the bathroom?
What are you talking about? Have you been drinking?
Have a nice day.
But listen, quiet, okay? I'm talking. Let the host talk. People will remember this show. They'll remember this time because, you know, I'm finally reinventing radio. I'm like Laszlo Marconi, you know? I've tried blogging, porn. I've tried Vinewood, glory holes, facefuls of pills. But screw that, you know? I'm not about dependency anymore. It's finally about me, you know? I mean, because I'm a good-looking guy. I got a six-pack, huh? Look at that, huh?
Oh, dude, don't show me your stomach. That's disgusting.
Hey, come back here. I'll show you my glutes.
Now leave me alone.
Come on, you made history. Let the John Wilkes Booth the radio. What is wrong with the people of Liberty City, you know? Don't they want to be famous? Excuse me, madam. Listen, you're live on the radio. Have you got anything to say?
What? No, my God.
Take your time, honey. This is the reality of live entertainment. Like when I put on a fat suit and go and feel up tourists. You know, or that thing that got me indicted. Are you finally ready?
What are you talking about?
No, it's okay. Take your time. No problem. You know, imagine you're a stud about to...
Hey, all of a sudden, a cop is after you. All of a sudden, their boyfriends are coming after you.